So good morning, students. Today I am going to start the new chapter, that is Introduction to C. C language. C language. So C language is a highly language. It is a whatever language. C language is a high language. It is made up of C language is a highly language, procedural programming language. It was developed by AT&T in Bell's laboratory in 1972. Before C, it was developed by C language is developed by Dennis Ritchie. Before C, it was known as BCPL. Before C, it was known as BCPL, which is also called B language. BCPL means Basic Combined Programming Language. It is also known as B language. Before C, the language is known as BCPL, which is also known as C language. The C language was used to code the Unix operating system. In 1978, Dennis Ritchie and Brian Cunningham published the first edition of the C programming language. The C programming language, which was commonly known as KNRC. So the name of the book is the C programming language. In 1988, the American National Standard Institute has formalized the C language. In 1988, ANSI, American National Standard Institute has formalized the C language. The Linux operating system, PHP, MySQL are all written in C language. Next, the C language, programming language. A computer programming within C is high-level language such as C++, C, C Sharp, COBOL, Java, etc. All are called the source program or the source code. C++, Java, COBOL, they are all known as source program, or which is also known as source code. S-O-U-R-C-E, source code. So all the high-level languages are written in source code, and the computer understand on machine language. So here we need to convert source code to object code. The machine language is known as object code. The C language is all the high-level languages are written in source code, which can be converted into object code. The source code need to be converted into a machine understandable form known as object code. So that means before any program can be executed in a computer, we need to convert from source code to object code. So who can convert it? The compiler or interpreter. Compiler, which I explained in the earlier also, compiler or interpreter. So these two things we need to convert source code to object code. See, the function of compiler and the interpreter are same. Both can convert high level language to machine language and machine language to high level language. But here see, some programming language use compiler, some programming language use compiler, and some programming language use interpreter to convert high level language to machine language. See, C++, C Sharp, these programming languages, COBOL, this programming language use compiler to convert high level language to low level language and low level language to machine language. But interpreter, BASIC, is an example of BASIC, also programming language, which can use interpreter to convert high level language to low level language. So next difference is that the compiler read the whole program at a time and convert into high level language to machine code, but interpreter read line by line and convert it into machine language line by line. This is the difference between compiler and interpreter. So I repeat it, compiler tested the whole program at a time, interpreter tested line by line program, line by line. Second thing, compiler is faster than the interpreter. Because compiler read whole program, then converted it, but interpreter read one line, converted, read second line, converted it, read third line, converted it. So it is slower than the compiler. Error free. It is difficult to find error in compiler. It is difficult to find error in compiler, but it is easy to find error in interpreter. Okay. So this is the difference between compiler and interpreter. Next, writing, editing, compiling, and running in C programming C can be done using a software called IDE. There is a software IDE, Integrated Development Environment. The C language uses IDE software. It is a text editor that works like a word processor. This text editor is work like a word processor. It also has a compiler for code translations, debugging for error detections, corrections, and loader to execute the compiler program. Turbo C++ for Windows 3.7, DOS version is one such IDE for C language. The IDE supports both C and C++. The compiler can recognize the program as C or C++ depending on the syntax. See, the functional, the C and C++ are same, the program is same. The compiler identifies either you are working the program with C or C++. I explain you how can the compiler identify you are working C or C++. Next is about working with C IDE. An IDE for C language is itself a program which must be installed on your computer before you can work with it. So if you want to work with C language, the C compiler or interpreter, C compiler must be installed in your computers. The C compiler used in the book Turbo C++ 3.7 for Windows. So how can open it? How to create a C source file? When you open a C, go to program, then click on C. When your C program is open, you can select file and go for new to creating a new source file. The second window, the if window, will appear inside the first. You can now type your programs. Type the program as shown in the figure 14.3. The program can be explained. I explain the later. The file you created as given. See, when you create your files and you have to save it, so you have to give the file name. So if you are not giving any file name, then default file name will appear. The default file name is noname.0.cpp. See, if you work with C language, then the secondary file name of C language is .c. And if you work in C++, then the secondary file name is .cpp. .c and .c is for C language, cpp for C++. So these are the two difference. Secondary file name, the first one is secondary file name for C language, second one is the secondary file name for C++ language. So when you're saving a file, you have to give the file name along with secondary file name. If you work with C language, give .c. If you work with C++, then give .cpp. So if you're not giving any file name, the file name will appear noname00. You can change the file name and give your own. So how to execute the files? To execute the files, click run or F2. Yes. Either you can place F2 or write run to execute the C program. So students, if you are computer at home, if you want to work with C language, download the C programs in your computer. So when I'm going to start the programs, you can check it at home. Wait. Next is the structure of C program. Structure of C program. The C program, the first line is has include stdio.h. If you are going to start any C program, the first line must be has include stdio.h. The full form of stdio means standard input output header file. In C program, the first line must be the header file, that is has include stdio.h. If you are working in C, but if you are working in C++, then the first line is has include iostream.h. So this is the difference between C and C++. So with the help of these two header files, the compiler identifies that either you are working C language or C++. If the first line is include stdio.h, that means the compiler understands that you are working in C language. But if you use the first line include iostream.h, then the compiler understood that you are working in C++ language. After include, the second line is include conio.h. So when you are going to start any C program, one thing remind in your mind that the first two lines must be given in the program. The first one is include stdio.h, the second line is include conio.h. After that, if you use main, empty brackets, main, then curly brackets. So whatever you write between these two curly brackets, that is the body of the programs. See, main, there are different types of mains: int main, main, void main, void. So I will explain the different types of main one by one in your next class. So let's go for the structure of C program. In C language, the line begins with the hash sign. Hash sign is called the line begins with the hash sign is called the preprocessor directive. It tells the preprocessor before completions to include the file stdio.h with the source code. Your C program, the file includes the declaration of the basic standard input and output functions such as printf, scanf, etc. So that you may use these functions in your program. Next is int main. So here I am using main. So you can also use int main. See, C language is a case sensitive. All the reserved word can be written in small letter. You cannot use any capital letter here. Reserve words, all the functions are written in small letter. It is a case sensitive language. If you use capital letter, because in C language the value of capital A and the value of small a are different. So you can use only the small letter in C language. Int main, this line marks the beginning of the main function. So from here the main function will be started. The main function is the entry point of the every C program. This is the entry point of the every C program. The execution of the C program is start in after the main function. So the execution of the program will be started. For this reason, all C program must have the one main function. There are four or five types of main functions are there, but every C program there is must one main functions are there. The word main is followed by the pair of parentheses. This is because it is a function declaration. This means here the functions are declared. After parentheses, the body of the main function is enclosed in a pair of curly brackets. Pair of curly brackets. This curly brace contains statements that are tested by the C compiler into machine code. So whatever you write it here, this part will be converted from machine language to source code to object code and object code to source code. Okay. Next, about the comments. In C, whatever you write between these two symbols, it is denoted as a comment. Whatever you write these two symbols, it is denoted as a comment. That means whatever you write, it will not execute in the program. Comment is for only for the general information about the program. It will not execute in the program. You can use comment anywhere in the top, bottom, middle, any of the programs, but it will not execute it. This is a command line. A command line begins with slash star and ends with star slash. You can have multiple lines between two pair of symbols. A command line is not translated by the compiler into machine language. The compiler simply ignores the command lines. Command lines are used by the programmer to include short explanations within the source code for better understanding and better readable for the program. After that, the command will get this printf. Don't give space between print and f. Printf, it is a output command. Scanf is used to insert data through the keyboards. Printf is used to print the output. This line is executable C statement. They actually produce the output of the program. The printf function is used for outputting. If you write printf, if you write printf, welcome, then it will display in the output. So whatever you write within double quotation mark with the statement printf, it will give the output, give the result in the output. So printf is declared in the stdio.h header file. So if you use stdio.h, then if you use scanf or printf for stdio.h, that means this is for C. And C++, the commands are different. Getch. This function is used for output window to halt till the user enter an input through the keyboard. That is getch. If you use getch command in a program, so the computer becomes halt until or unless you are not inserting any key from the keyboard. The function is used for the output window to halt till the user enter any input through the keyboard. The getch function is also declared in the stdio.h header file. Next command is return 0. See, the return statement calls the main function. If you use main in the program, then the last line before the curly bracket must be return 0. The return statement calls the main function to end. The return statement is followed by the return code. Therefore, the return code is 0. The return code means the program works as expected without any error during its execution. This is the most usual way to end the C program. So, in a C program, the first line is pre-processed directive, second is your main functions, third is your command line, and the most important things, when you're going to write any program in C, any statement, you can use semicolon. You can use semicolon. This is used semicolon. So this is used to terminate the program. To terminate the statement, you have to use semicolon at the end of the program. So these are the basic structure of the C programs. The next classes, I will show you how to structure the C programs, and I will have a one program. I will show you the different statement in C language one by one. Thank you.